Just like humans at rush hour, bats leave their caves in a mass exodus, at first in a great crush and later at a trickle.
I've stood around outside of many caves when bats came out. That's part of my job. And in all those times that I've stood outside the bat caves, I've never seen two bats crash into each other. They come very close, but they never crash.
How do bats do it? Mueller and graduate students are parsing the mechanics of bat echolocation to discover their secrets. He suspects the bats have dynamic capabilities, which he demonstrates.
Well, sophisticated bats speak through the nose, not through the mouth. Around the nose there's a little megaphone, and while the sound is coming out of the nose, the walls of this megaphone are in motion, so they're twitching all the time. And then the sound travels out, the echoes come back. When the echoes come back, they're received at the ears, and again, the ears are not hanging statically on the sides of the head, but again, the ears are in motion while the sound is impinging on them.
Mueller joined other Virginia Tech researchers in Newport News recently so private sector leaders could do some hypothesizing of their own on how the skills of bats might apply to industry. Some bat species live in dense thickets, which they fly through at breakneck speeds without touching anything.
Natural environments, say dense forests, pose a big problem to human navigation, say to drones that want to fly into those. If you have an underwater sonar and you are in a shallow water environment with a lot of structure on the seafloor, you encounter just the same type of problem. And the only difference is that the bats can solve it and our naval sonars cannot yet.
At the Newport News event, graduate student Christopher Watford demonstrated a bat-like sonar head attached to a drone. Research like this
will lead to much more effective solutions that are essentially artificial but mimic what nature has done so well over the millennia.
The sonar heads enable the researchers to better understand what the bats are doing. U.S. Navy engineers are partners on the project. The result could improve communications in the world's oceans.
Bats show us that these problems can be solved.
For Outreach and International Affairs, this is Andrea Brunet reporting.